realize how good it feels to see that Christmas intro again. I haven't seen it since, what, last year? But anyway, I am going to be doing a more simple Christmas look today. Very sparkly, very glittery, and it's simple because there's not a lot put into it and not a lot of different colors. I wanted to keep it toned down and focus more on one type of color and then, you know, just have that pop of color on the lip. So I'm going to start off with the NYX, This is the NYX eyeshadow pencil in the shade Milk. I use this as a base to make colors pop, but this time I wanted to use it as a like a white base under like the crystal look that I'm going to be doing rather than using just a regular concealer or eyeshadow primer. And I am doing it in sort of like an angle, so that's why I'm just applying it with the stick first. And then I'm going back in with the brush to make sure it's even on the lid. To clean it up above the lid, I am going in with some Q-tips, and I'm using these Olaf Q-tips because I found this at the Dollar Tree in a canister and I lost my Q-tips, but I'm just using it dry just to clean it up and again make it even, make sure it's not messy. I just always need it to be even on both sides, and most of the time I can't get it even, so this is the best way. And by the way, I did not apply concealer under my brows to clean them up because I knew from the previous looks that I've done, putting the concealer under the brows would mix right in with this eyeshadow base and it would just be messy. For this part, I'm going in with three different palettes to figure out which colors I want to use. I'm going to start off with this Oakland Matte Metal eyeshadow palette and use that deep silver tone. Now this is more like, it feels like a cushion because it moves around. I don't know what you would call this eyeshadow. But I'm also going in with the Disney Mulan palette, and I'm going to be swatching those two top shades, and they are also like a silver crystal tone. I don't know. Yeah, I'm just going with that. And then the last one is the Bad Habit After Party palette, and this one seems more like a pressed glitter eyeshadow, and that's the last swatch. So I ended up going in with the Mulan palette and using that first shade Core Reflection. I was like, instead of holding these palettes showing you guys what which one I'm going in with, I was like, I'll just put it on the screen if I have to, but I don't think I have to because I already showed it. But I'm going to apply the shade Reflection all over the lid, and it's like a, I don't know what you would call it, it's like a silver eyeshadow. It's like a light silver and it reflects so beautifully, hence the name Reflection. And now I'm going in with the Oakland Matte and Metal eyeshadow palette, and I'm using that deep silver gray eyeshadow and applying it like liner. I figure that when I go in with the glitter it would stick on this because this has like, I don't know, like a creamy texture to it. It's hard to explain this type of eyeshadow. I've never had an eyeshadow like this, which is why I like it. If you apply this eyeshadow on the lid by itself, it will crease. So I don't know what you would call this eyeshadow, but it's very pretty. I'm just applying it across the lid like I would winged liner. Now I'm going in with these two silver types of glitter. One is like a little fine thin glitter and the other one is a little bit more chunky, mixing them together, spraying my brush and then applying it on that eyeshadow that I created as liner. Now I'm also going to apply it on top of that shade on a lid, and I'm going to apply it from the outer wing part halfway across in the crease. I don't know what I was doing. I was kind of just like thinking about this look as I go. Most of my looks are not planned, so if there's a look that I want to create, I'll just think of it as I go, which is what I'm doing here. And yep, that's pretty much all that I did. Not much to it. And I didn't use a glitter primer because I was like, I really didn't feel like doing it. So that's why I just sprayed the brush and hope that it would stick, and it did. I already did foundation and concealer off camera. It's the same ones that I've been using for the past couple of videos to get rid of. Now I'm going to go in with the e.l.f. cream bronzer and powder bronzer duos on the face. I don't remember what the cream one is called, but I think the powder one was like Turks and Caicos or something, or maybe that's backwards, I don't know. But I'm going in with the cream one first, applying with a brush, and then blending it with the sponge. For powder, I'm going to set with the Black Radiance Yellow or Banana. I think it's called Banana Powder. I don't have any of these products in front of me. That's why I'm just guessing the name, but I think it is the Banana Powder. And I'm setting that with a sponge. And then I'm going to press it in. And by the way, I am using my Japanese sponge for this part. I did clean the other sponge, and that's why I didn't really want to use it, because when I used it in my other video, it's a white sponge and I hate getting it dirty. So I'm like, let me just keep using my Japanese sponge. And this is the one where I can actually press the powder into my skin and it would look flawless and it wouldn't apply too much powder. Now I'm going in with that e.l.f. bronzer, the one that's broke, that I put into the Lancôme bottle that I use for bronzer. I'm just using whatever is left in here. I actually broke it in a video that was like the Lion King inspired video. So that's why I'm just using whatever is left. And as you guys can see, there was some product left in that thing that I didn't realize. But when you apply something too harsh, just go in with powder and blend it out. Now I'm going in with the Becca Cosmetics Sun Chaser palette. And I'm using that blush that's in there. I didn't know which blush to use. I didn't want to use the orange one, so I used this more pink tone. For highlighter, I'm using this LA Colors one that's only a dollar, and that was at the Dollar Tree. I did like a whole video on it. It's such a beautiful highlighter. It's like a light gold with more gold in it, and it's perfect. It's subtle at first, and then you could build it up to however you want it to look, and it's only a dollar. I try to keep this video as inexpensive as possible, so more like drugstore, but still with a little bit of high-end in there, and this is one of my favorites. These lashes are by a brand called Ioni. I had never heard of these lashes before, and I found these at the Dollar Tree. They had like a whole section of them, and they are 3D foaming lashes, cruelty free as well. They're very wispy and dramatic. They had a couple of different styles, but these two were the ones that I gravitated towards the most, because I was like, wow, a dollar for these lashes and they look this dramatic. I was like, I have to try these. Now the thing about these lashes, I'm going in with the dramatic full crisscross ones, is that the band on the lashes is very, very hard and thick, so it's very hard to adjust to your eye shape, which is why it's giving me such a hard time right now to apply it, because when the band is really hard, when you apply it on one side, the other side will pop up. So I don't like lashes like these with the hard band, but you know, they were a dollar, and as you guys can see, very excellent quality for the price. I just don't like the band, but other than that, they're so pretty and very wispy, and I love wispy and dramatic. The other ones look very dramatic, so maybe I'll use those in a different video, I don't know. Of course I'm gonna use them in a different video, I ain't waste no dollar. But yeah, I went in with these and they look so good. They just gave me such a hard time to apply. So I finally got them on. They're still like a little wonky looking, but they're glued down, and that's all that matters. I think I'll have to trim them a little bit more. Now for the waterline, I'm going in with the Marc Jacobs Glam Jam Liner. I didn't know if I wanted to do this or the white Maybelline eyeliner, but I went in with this one, and I'm going to apply that on the waterline and then drag it down to the lower lash line just to have that pop, so I don't have to apply eyeshadow. I just wanted this color because, you know, just a little pop of color. It's a nice contrast between the silver, this liner, and like my red shirt. Now I'm going in with the NYX mascara. I forgot what this is called, and I just seen it on the screen. And I'm just applying this to the lower lash line. Now for lips, I didn't know which red I wanted to go in with, so I have this Anastasia one in the shade Seraphine. I have this Iman one. This is Iman's red, which is more like a creamy red. The Anastasia dries down matte. And then this one is Max Ruby Woo, and this is a matte one as well. So I went in with Anastasia because I knew that this would dry down to a deeper red, and that's what I wanted to kind of match with the liner, and that will complete this look. I also added crystals in the inner corner because you guys know I'm obsessed with crystals, and it would not be my type of look without the gem. So I hope you guys enjoy. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!